Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to discuss all the important questions from this chapter, Lost Spring, which is written by Anish Jung. Okay, so without wasting time, let us start with the first question. Discuss the theme of the story. There are five themes which are discussed in the story. First is forced labor, illiteracy, exploitation of elite class, insensitive politicians, call to break shackles. Okay, now here, children were forced to work. Okay, because they were illiterate. Why they were illiterate? Because elite people did not want them to learn. Alright, because they exploited them, that they were under poverty throughout their life. Therefore, they could not get education and they had to work. Okay, they were very insensitive because of the insensitive politicians who did not have any emotional attachment with countrymen. Okay, they were the culprit as well. Then lack of, call to break shackles. The old traditions are still prevailing. Nobody wants to change their profession. That is also another problem which is discussed in this story. Okay, let's move to the second question. What is Sahib looking for in the garbage dumps? It is Sahib, who is a rag picker, who is looking out for gold. And here gold does not mean literal gold, okay, which we get from a jewelry shop. It means anything useful, because Sahib-e-Alam was poor, and if he will get anything useful by selling which he can get money, then it is going to be considered as gold. It is going to be as valuable as gold. That is why through hyperbole, okay, through exaggeration, this is being highlighted. Next we see question number 3. Where is he and where has he come from? Now, Sahib-e-Alam is in Simapuri, and his main place, his main country is Bangladesh. From there he migrated to India during the war between India and Pakistan in the year 1971. Okay, next point. Let's move to the next question. What explanation does the author offer for the children not wearing footwear? They say that it is an ancient tradition, but it is not. It is utter poverty. It is forced necessity. Why forced necessity? Because of utter poverty. Alright. Next we will see question number 5. Question number 5 is, is Sahib happy working at the tea stall? Explain. No, he is not happy at all, because he is not his own master now. He has lost carefree look, and there is no spring left in him. When he was a rag picker, he was very carefree and he had freedom. But here, he has lost his freedom. He has lost his cheerfulness, okay? Charm of the childhood, etc. And he is bound by time. At a specific time, he has to reach to the tea stall, and at night, he has to leave at a specific time. And this has become very burdensome for him. And he is answerable to his master. Okay, if something wrong he has to answer his master. Okay, let's move to the next question. Question number 6 is, mention the hazards of working in the glass bangle industry. First thing is lacking poor infrastructure and basic amenities. Firozabad is disorganized, ill-lit, ill-ventilated, dingy hovels with high temperatures, unhygienic condition, lack of protective gear, okay, for eyes. Unchanged fixed posture ages them early. So these are the points that you have to mention, and its explanation I have already done in my video of Lost Spring. Okay, where I have done line wise explanation. You all can take help of that in order to have explanation of all this. Let's move to the next question, number 7. What forces conspire to keep the workers in the bangle industry of Firozabad in poverty? Lack of education, it is number 1. Lack of awareness about their rights and about their facilities. Okay, then stigma. They think that they are born in bangle making community, so they have to take up bangle making only. Okay, this is the stigma that is ruining their life. Next, craftiness of the sahukars. Very cunning behavior of sahukar, middlemen, politicians and policemen who always suppress these workers. Because of them also, common people are not upgrading their lifestyle at all. Okay, broken spirit. They have tried many times, but they did not find any change. Therefore, they had to resolve to their present situation. Lack of initiative. Nobody takes initiative. They are happy with whatever kind of life they are leading. They earn, they live. They earn, they live. Okay, but they don't think of changing their lifestyle. That is the problem. Next. Fear of being beaten and dragged to jail. There is a connection between sahukar, middleman, politician and police. Okay, police, they don't take support of these glass bangle makers. Okay, they always think about their commission from sahukars, middlemen and politicians. Therefore, they are also one of the culprits. Okay, then lack of leadership. Now, who will initiate the movement? Who will initiate the fight? Okay, or change? There should be somebody to lead them. Okay, but because of lack of education, I told you, they don't have proper knowledge. Okay, they don't know about the jail, police, courts thing, and therefore they are very much scared. And another thing is that if they will miss out their work for one day, their family will be in trouble. They will have to remain hungry, and because of that also they don't take initiative. And not only that, they know that even if somebody starts, they will be shattered by these four people. Okay, so that is the problem. Next, let's move to the next question. How is Sahib's name full of irony? Sahib-e-Alam literally means Lord of Universe. Okay, Lord of Universe, the God who is looking after entire universe, but he himself is in poverty. He himself does not have a house. He himself is malnutritioned. Okay, he himself has to go out and clean the garbage. All right, just like scavenger birds. So these are the explanation. This is the explanation. That is why his name is ironic. Okay. Despite being refugees, how do people in Simhapuri have ration cards? Okay, number one, refugees. It means a large vote bank for political parties. Ration cards allows them to vote. Refugees are concerned about grains than growth. Refugees, they just want grain. They don't think about the growth of the nation. Okay, so, and politicians also have sole motive of getting votes. Therefore, they have ration card, but their life is pathetic. Okay, let's move to the next. Explain the use of literary device in the sentence, an army of barefoot boys who appear like the morning birds and disappear at noon. First of all, army of barefoot boys, there we find metaphor. Metaphor are of two types, metaphor of quality and metaphor of quality. Here, metaphor of quantity, okay, is mentioned here. Metaphor of quantity, largeness of the group. Okay, next is like birds. It is simile, because like is used here. Okay, now boys are compared with scavenger birds, those birds who clean our society, like crow, okay, like eagle, etc. Now birds are another comparison is that birds are free spirited, so are the boys. The boys, they don't have time to go out of the house, they don't have time to come in. Okay, they are not bound by anything, they are just like birds. Okay, so this is how comparison is being done. Next we see, why does the author describe children of slum as partners in survival? Number one, they are offspring or children of homeless rat pickers. So unless and until they work, they are not going to feed their families. Parents are poverty stricken. Because of their poverty, they are not able to send their children for any other education, any kind of education, sorry. Children ought to work for survival. If they will not work, they will not be able to eat for that day. Now, garbage scrounging is a game rather than job. For parents, it is way of earning. Okay, it is a means of survival. But for children, it is a kind of game. If they find 10 rupees note, then they are going to find more. And because of this act, they get motivated. Okay, so definition is different, but they are forced to do this because of the problems that is discussed here. Next, we see question number 12. What changes occur in life of Sahib? Is it a change for the better or the worse? First of all, of course, it is for better if we consider monetary aspect. Okay, and it is respectable job as well. Compared to rag picking, this working in stall is more respectable job for him. And it gives him fixed income as well, but at the cost of his freedom. He is not free to do whatever he wish. Okay. Alright, next move to question number 13. Sahib wanted to be a master of his own destiny. Comment. Yes, he wanted to be. But what happened? Let us see. He was tired of stereotypical job of rag picking. Every day he had to do it. Some day he used to get 1 rupees, some day 100, some day he had to return empty handed. Okay? He wanted to play like affluent children. This example is given of tennis. Okay, when he watched that game of tennis in a very intense manner, it shows that he was interested in playing the same. And for that, maybe for that also he wanted to change his profession to earn some money. Okay. Last point is he wanted to master his destiny, but further put himself in slavery. He wanted to become his own master. Okay. He wanted to earn money so that he will be able to lead life according to his own will. But further he became, he was enslaved by this job because he had to work under the instructions of the owner. Okay.
Is Mukesh's sister-in-law's life different from that of Mukesh? No, it is not different at all. Both are burdened. Both lost their childhood. Mukesh confined to factory, but Mukesh Bhabhi is confined to four walls. She is in charge of three men, Mukesh, her husband and father-in-law. And even Mukesh is one of the members to shoulder the financial responsibility of the family. So both of them, both Mukesh and Bhabhi, who are of almost same age, have lost their childhood. Okay. Next, question number 15. Mukesh grandmother's views on the family occupation. Grandmother is a fatalist. She thinks that whatever is happening, that is happening for a reason and that cannot be changed. Okay. No one can change destiny. And this is the belief of grandmother.
But we have ample of examples where we find people have changed their life. She has seen her husband going blind, could not improve living condition. Now she had seen her husband doing same work continuously, because of which he became blind as well, and he could not improve his lifestyle throughout the tenure. Therefore she believes that nothing can be done in their life. Okay, same struggle of all. She can see around her grandmother, she can see lots of people suffering from the same condition. Therefore she silently accepts it as destiny. Had she seen any changes, she would have tried of changing it, changing her way of perception, but it did not happen. Okay. The last question, 16th number question is, will wearing bangles on her wedding day that she helps make eventually change Savita's life? See, here we find paradox. Okay, paradox means two contrast situation, acceptable at the same time. Now, first thing, they make beautiful bangles, colorful bangles, but their own life is bleak. Their own life is full of darkness. There is no proper food, there is no proper shelter, there is no happiness in their life. Okay. Next, bangles signify Suhag or husband. And because of these bangle making, Suhag, okay, they are going blind, they are becoming ill, they are dying before time. So it is paradox, of course. Okay, they are bringing happiness to others' life, but their own life is full of darkness because of bangle making. All right, and Savita is going to have similar life till education replaces child labor and child marriage. This is the only means. This is education is the only way out of this situation. Let's move to the last page. Why are people of Firozabad averse to the cooperative movement? This is very important question, students, for long question answers. First of all, you have to mention lack of education. Then awareness and acute poverty. Because of lack of education, they don't know about their rights, about their facilities, and whatever illegal is being done to them. Okay, they are unaware. Awareness, lack of awareness, I already told you here. Okay. Then acute poverty. You see, now, if they are not able to read, write, then how they are going to be aware? Okay, because there are people, there are educated people who are not going to help them out, right? And acute poverty. Every day they have to work and they have to eat. They cannot skip a day as well. Therefore, this discourages them to have a cooperative movement. Okay, they fear organizing into a cooperative movement. There are a lot many things which we see in movies as well. Okay, when they try to unite and fight against the owners, then they bring
goons into the scene and then they are beaten up. Okay, and wrath of police who are for the service of the common people, they are also favoring politicians, elite people, affluent people. Therefore, because of their wrath, because of their anger, they are very much fearful. Okay. Now, no proper leadership. Everybody is uneducated. Who is going to tell them what to do? Who is going to guide them? Therefore, because of lack of leadership as well, And the leader not only should have education but courage as well, which is lagging in all the people, right? Now, intimidation of politicians, sahukars and middlemen, okay? And apart from that, police as well. These four people have ruined the life of Firozabad bangle makers. Therefore, they are not able to have a cooperative movement, okay? At last, how can we eliminate child labor? This can come in article writing as well. So, please give utter importance, okay? Equal right to education. Everybody should get equal right where they can learn, where they can become educated. Ban on child labor everywhere. We should announce, okay, with the help of all the medias, all the means, we should stop child labor. We should make the announcement. Then if somebody is practicing the same, okay, being very adamant, then they should be given a stringent punishment by the government, and not only by the government, but by society as well. Children are future of the nation. Of course, they are future of the nation and they should be given utter importance. Alright, but we are not able to do that, and that is why child labor is flourishing. Okay. Public awareness, print media, audio and visual, all media's help we should take in order to aware people. Enforcement of law. There should be stringent punishment if somebody goes against the law of child labor. Okay. Children up to 14 years of age must get free and compulsory education. There might be parents, okay, just like parent of Sahib-e Alam Mukesh, who are not rich enough to send them to the school. Therefore, they should send them, government should make free and compulsory education so that they can get education out there. And the government is doing so well right now because free and compulsory education is there. Apart from this, they are getting midday meal as well. Not only that, they are getting incentives from the government, okay, and this will encourage them to learn more. Job for parents. See, if children are going to the school, then automatically parents need some support, financial support. Okay, if parents' job is secure, then there won't be any question of sending their children for the work. So there should be proper job for parents as well, and job for children after education.
Most of the people think that what to do after education if they have to go back to rag picking, if they have to go to the tea stall, if they have to go to the factories. Okay, therefore there should be proper
job for all the children who get good education,
okay, who complete their education properly. So by this we have completed our question answers. All the best everyone. We will meet in our next video. Thank you.